This video is going to be on understanding the user interface. Understanding the user interface is important because you will be deeply involved in the interface at all times. Think of this as a guided tour so that you can find where you need to be more easily during your project work. First, let's look at the menu browser. It's the big A in the upper left-hand corner. This is going to have things like new, open, save, and save as, plot and publish, also drawing utilities. Right next to the menu browser is the quick access toolbar. This is a series of tools that are easier to get to than inside the menu browser. They're up here all the time. Here you'll see there's the new button, open, save, plot, and undo. If you want to add more tools to the quick access toolbar, you just right click and choose them. I like to have the layer manager up there, so I'll right click on that tool and say add to quick access toolbar, and there it is. Another thing about the quick access toolbar is the new command. Actually, it's the QNew version of that command, which means that it will start a file with a predetermined template file. That way it's easier to get to your standards every time you start Civil 3D. Next thing we'll look at is the tool space. Tool space is broken up into Prospector, Settings, Survey, and Toolbox tabs. The Prospector is where we're going to interact with objects, like the surface in our file here is actually listed out underneath the surfaces here. The name is Existing. I can right-click on it and get to the surface properties from this location. If I go to the Settings tab holds styles, labels, and commands available for controlling objects that you've created. If I expand Surfaces, you'll see that there's an Object Style or the Surface Style here. It's got styles that I can assign to make the surface look different. The definition of the surface is mathematical, but this is a way that we can visualize that definition. If I go to the label styles, labels are controlled separately from the object styles so that they can report information no matter how the surface looks. Here you can see the labels are broken into contour, slope, spot elevation, and watershed, specifically for the surface object. If I go to the commands, commands are macros that run every time you start a certain command. If I look at the Create Surface command, which I used to build the surface originally, I'll right-click on it and edit command settings. In here, besides drawing settings, I can also go into Surface Defaults, Default Styles, including what style the surface will be created with when it's first created, or different build options. Right below the Settings tab is the Survey tab. This is holding the survey database and settings that control the import and export of data into different files. The Toolbox is below that. The Toolbox holds reports and report settings, miscellaneous functions, and specialized new tools. If you want to run one of these reports or special tools, you right-click and choose Execute. Near the top of the window screen here is the ribbon. The ribbon is a gathering of different icons and tools and commands. The ribbon is divided up into tabs. Right now we're on the Home tab, Insert, Annotate, and so forth. These are just groupings of different commands that help facilitate easy workflows. Each tab is broken up into panels. This panel here is called the Palettes. This panel is the Create Ground Data, and so forth. Panels are just further groupings of similar tools. Some of the panels have a little arrow indicating that the panel will pull down to reveal more tools in that area. These are tools that have been found not to be used consistently, but it's good to have quick access to them. If you find yourself using these tools consistently, you may want to thumbtack them down so that they don't roll away from you. After you're done using it, you just unthumbtack and it rolls back up into the ribbon. The ribbon can also become what's called a context ribbon. If I select an object, the ribbon becomes a green color to indicate that it's in contextual mode and then displays only tools that are available for the object that you've selected. It pares down the tools that are available. That way, the other things aren't getting in your way. By the way, if this context ribbon ever gets very short like this, it means that you have more than one type of item selected. Like I have alignments and surface here. To get your tools back, just hit Escape and then reselect the object that you wanted to work with. With an object selected in the green context ribbon, you'll be able to get to that object's properties. This is just different control mechanisms for that particular object. All objects have an information tab which allow you to change the name or the style, but the other tabs will be very specific to the operation of that object. Some objects, when you start to create them, will provide you with a toolbar. These toolbars hold specific tools for creating specific objects. Generally, they're laid out in object creation order from left to right. Some also have a chevron that open up to more settings and styles and options. These are things that you may need to get to quickly, but don't want to have open all the time, so you can close them while you use the rest of the toolbar.